Sleep apnea is a disorder that has been estimated to affect around 25% of the population between 30 and 70 years of age. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. Sleep physiology refers to the study of how and why we sleep. Simply put, sleep is a state in which there is an absence of wakefulness that is metabolically regulated and essential for human life. A sleep disorder is a condition that affects the quality, duration, timing, or impact of a patient's ability to sleep or function properly while awake. And it just so happens that sleep apnea is the most common sleep disorder. To be a bit more specific, sleep apnea is a disorder characterized by repeated episodes without breathing while asleep that last for at least 10 seconds or longer. There are two primary types, obstructive and central sleep apnea. Obstructive sleep apnea is characterized by the absence of breathing while asleep that is caused by a blockage of the upper airway. It is often associated with obesity. With this type, breathing efforts are being made by the patient, but the airflow is blocked in the back of the throat. Some examples of the common causes of obstructive sleep apnea include upper airway abnormalities, tonsillar hypertrophy, a large neck, small chin, or increased soft tissue around the neck. A diagnosis of obstructive sleep apnea can be made using a sleep study, also known as polysomnography. It records the patient's brain activity, eye movements, muscle activity, and heart rhythm during sleep. The treatment for obstructive sleep apnea involves the use of non-invasive ventilation, which applies positive pressure to the airway in order to reduce the number of apnea episodes. CPAP is the most common type, although BiPAP may be used in some cases. Also, the use of a specialized mouthpiece can be helpful to reposition the jaw forward, which opens up the airway so that breaths can flow more freely. Supplemental oxygen may be indicated in some cases. And if non-invasive treatment methods are not effective, the doctor may recommend a surgical procedure to correct the anatomical abnormalities causing the airway blockage. Now let's talk about central sleep apnea. Central sleep apnea is a disorder characterized by the absence of breathing while asleep that is caused by a medullary depression that inhibits an inspiratory effort. It is characterized by a lack of drive to breathe during sleep in which the patient does not make any breathing efforts. It differs from obstructive sleep apnea because with that type, breathing efforts are being made by the patient, but the airflow is blocked by an obstruction. In central sleep apnea, the apnea periods aren't caused by a blocked airway. They occur because the portion of the brain that controls breathing isn't functioning properly. This results in no respiratory effort, insufficient ventilation, and compromised gas exchange. Some examples of the common causes of central sleep apnea include a stroke, muscular dystrophy, Guillain-Barré syndrome, ALS, congestive heart failure, chronic opiate use, and congenital abnormalities. A diagnosis for central sleep apnea can also be confirmed using polysomnography. The treatment for central sleep apnea involves caring for any underlying issue that may be causing the condition. Non-invasive ventilation machines can be used while the patient is sleeping to reduce periods of apnea. This includes both BiPAP and CPAP devices. And supplemental oxygen may also be indicated. But again, for this video, we just wanted to provide you with a brief overview of the different types of sleep apnea. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. But real quick, if you don't mind, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And you might as well go ahead and subscribe for more videos like this. Hopefully what you learned in this video was useful and can help you develop a better understanding of this topic. If so, be sure to let us know down in the comment section below. And if you want to dive even deeper, we do have a full guide on our website. I will drop a link to it right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.